Welding for Beginners in Fabrication, The Essentials of the Welding Craft. Written by Roger Scates, narrated by Derek Newman. Introduction. Everyone is familiar with the concept of welding, and quite a few people have picked up the skill as a hobby. Basically, welding is the process of joining two pieces of metal using heat. The joint of a weld that is well done looks clean and is hard to detect. Welding can be intimidating to some people since you need to work with extreme heat. An accident can be even fatal. That is why you need the right gear in addition to some safety practices if you want to try it out. When you get used to it, the welding process can even be fun. Welding is a common industrial process, often seen in construction. But it also has some applications in your home as well. With this skill, you can make some quick repairs by yourself, thus saving time and money. When trying to master a new craft, having the right foundation can drastically reduce the learning curve. This book offers exactly that, a solid foundation on which you can build your welding mastery. The art of welding takes a lot of time and practice. That is why a book cannot contain all the information that will magically turn you into an expert welder. Nothing beats the experience of a true master. However, this book tries to help you start on the right path and give you the right basics that can turn a beginner into an expert. The welding craft is explained as a whole, which allows you to see the big picture. With patience, practice, and dedicated effort, you too can become a master welder. Getting started. If you're picking up welding as a profession, then you'll need a couple of welder certifications and licenses. Basically, you need to follow certain procedures which help determine if you have the skills and abilities to produce an acceptable weld. Most of the time, the test is conducted according to a code. There are many organizations out there that offer such a test. Most of the certifications have an expiration date, but you can always renew or extend your certifications under different requirements. Before you get started with welding, you need to make some preparations. You need to have certain gear and tools. Welding can be dangerous and can cause severe damage if you're not careful. This chapter will address both the equipment you need, how to maintain it for extended use, as well as safety procedures. Workplace safety. In order to have a safe working experience, you need to make sure that your workplace is free from any possible hazards. Dangers of fires and explosions are always present when you're welding. Welding spatter and fires from hot metal can cause severe burns without proper protective equipment. The fumes coming from the welding can be toxic. You're also prone to fatal electric shocks. There are also other work hazards you need to be aware of, such as dust, which may accumulate to a dangerous level. Noise, vibration, and radiation are some of the most common. Here are some safety procedures you should definitely follow. General health and safety in welding. Before you start welding, make sure that your workplace is free from any combustible materials. If possible, remove everything you do not need from your workplace. If you plan to weld in your garage, make sure that no flammable or combustible materials are in the area. You can never tell when a wild spark might fly off and set things alight. If you smell gas, do not light any gas torches or use electric welding equipment. Still, do not rely on your sense of smell entirely. When you have your equipment on, it can be difficult to smell gas. When you're welding, make sure your eyes are protected and your skin is covered from the arc flash. We will talk about safety equipment later on. Assume that everything is hot, just like how you would assume that every gun is loaded. Keep your gloves on whenever you work and never touch the metal with your bare hands while you're welding. Fire and explosion prevention. First off, prevent the ignition of combustible materials that might be near the welding process. If you're welding a metal wall or partition, or you're welding near one, it's a good idea to check what's behind it. When it comes to gas equipment, you should keep all regulators and air hoses free from oil and grease because pressurized oxygen can cause these two to spontaneously combust. Also, avoid getting grease or oil on your hands, gloves, or clothing. When you weld, use the right gas for the right situation. Never, ever substitute oxygen for compressed air. If you're working in confined spaces, then there is a higher risk of having the fuel gases combining with the air to ignite or explode. Therefore, make sure that the welding gas supply line does not lie in a confined space where leaking is possible. Moreover, have fire extinguishers ready in easily accessible locations and learn how to use them. You should also watch out for explosion hazards. When you're welding, cutting, brazing, soldering on pipes, tanks, drums, or other vessels, you run the risk of causing an explosion if you're not careful. Every container that was used to store petrol or other flammable substances is very dangerous to work on. A pinpoint of heat can be enough to trigger an explosion or fire. Other containers that are used to store oil, soap, diesel oil, acids, those that react with metal to produce hydrogen, should be avoided.
If your project involves...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.